Hello students, today's topic is affine transformation. It is coming from the unit 2 where we have discussed about the transformation. In that time I forgot to tell you about this transformation because this is not too much important, but I saw somewhere there is one this type of question is coming on the question paper. That's why I want to tell you and I want to explain to you. Maybe in this time if this type of question is coming, then you can solve it. Okay, so affine transformation is just the same as the another transformations. So here affine transformations are doing something to every part of an object, object plane, object point and lines. Okay, so means that affine means you have to do something more about that thing. Okay, just like the research. Okay, this is called the affine. So if you are using some transformation technique on that point, this is called the affine transformation. So affine transformation is just how line, point, plane are allowed to be transformed. Okay, so whenever you have to use affine transformation, then first of all you have to check these properties are on that object or not. If these properties are there, then only you can do affine transformation. So what are the properties are there? First is collinearity. What is collinearity? Collinearity between points is preserved, means that if any point is one object and after transformation another object is coming, so point are same. Okay, it doesn't like if A is there and after transformation A will not be there. Okay, so these type of things are not happened. So this is called the points is preserved. Another one is parallelism. Parallelism means parallel lines remains parallel. If one rectangle is here and you are using some transformation on the that rectangle and another object is coming, new object coordinates are coming, so whatever parallel lines are in the old object, same thing new object have also. So parallel lines are also same as parallel. Okay, another one is lines map to lines. Lines map to lines means preserve ratio of distance between points line on line. Okay, the same thing, whatever line ratio are old object, same thing happened in the new object also after transformation. But angles can be differ. Okay, but angles can be differ. It can be preserved or it cannot be. There is not a strictly rule. Okay, so these three things have to be preserved: collinearity, parallelism and lines maps to lines. Okay, so what are the examples, how can type of transformation we can use in the affine? Translation, as you know, in the 2D transformation, as I told you before, scaling also, reflection also, composite means more than one, more than two or more than one transformations are using each other simultaneously, and shearing also, you know, rotation also, you know. Homothety means if 3 points are there and those 3 lines are meeting in one point. Okay, so if that meeting point, if we consider is steering. Okay, so means that if one position of one point, those 3 lines are meeting and that point are transformed any another point, so that you can see those three lines are meeting with one point but in another end, that will be going far away from each other. This is called the homothety. Okay, so here how we can solve and how we can use the affine transformation in 2D. So consider a point PXY, then affine transformation of P are all transformed that can be written as. So P dash means new object coordinate is equal to, I'm sorry, transform that can be written as P dash is equal to AX plus BY plus C, DX plus CY plus F. for x ax plus by and for y dx plus cy plus f, where a to f are scalar quantities. Okay, so for an example here in this part, four conditions are there. According to that four conditions, all transformation techniques can be used. For example, a1 a comma e is equal to 1 and b comma d is equal to 0. In this matrix you can see if a and e will be 1 and b and d will be 0, then we can get pure translation. Now you can see here a will be 1 and b is equal to 0, so ax plus c here you can get, and here d will be 0 and e will be 1. So here you can see y plus f, get it? So here x plus c and y plus f, this is the pure translation. Now you can see x plus c and y plus f, here this is the pure translation. Second point, if b d c f is equal to 0, then pure scaling. Here you can see b c d f, then what is coming? Ax and cy. Okay, so ax and cy is coming, it means this is pure scaling. Now here third point, if ae is equal to cos theta, if ae is equal to cos theta and b is equal to minus sine theta, d is equal to sine theta and cf are 0, then you can get pure rotation. Now you can see x cos theta minus y sine theta, x sine theta plus y cos theta. You can see. Next, last point is if AE is equal to 1, if AE is equal to 1 and CF is equal to 0, then what is coming? X plus BY and D plus Y. So you can see here X plus BY, Y plus AX. X plus BY, A and E is equal to 1, A and E is equal to 1. So x plus by and y plus dx. Sorry, here some misprinting is coming. By mistake I wrote here ax, but here dx has to be there. Okay, so here x plus by, y plus dx. Okay, so don't be confused, here y plus dx will be coming. So here you can see shearing, pure shearing transformation is coming. So like this you can use affine transformation. So in the general formula of matrix of affine transformation 2D, p dash is equal to ax plus by plus c dx plus ey plus f, where a to f are the scalar. So what are the advantages are there? Here used to correct geometric distortion, means that whenever you are taking satellite images, then maybe it will be so much blur. So for that purpose you have to use affine transformation. By this you can see image are too much clear. Okay, that will not be blur. Another advantage are there, preserve convex hull properties in Bezier curve. If you understand about the Bezier curve in my last videos, you can understand what is the convex hull. So that convex hull will be preserved by the affine transformation. Okay, so I hope you all understand about the today's topic, affine transformation. Thank you.